it's hard to know exactly where the screw channel will be. This is the maximal angulation that you have. You can't have it more palatal. You don't have to use implant level scan abutment.
Hi, welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Hello, Yaniv.
Hello.
How are you?
Great.
Good to hear. What did you bring us today?
Today, what I want to talk about is making an immediate restoration on immediate implantation in cases when you have a lot of multi-units. Mm-hmm. And in this process, we'll discuss when and how you choose between straight and angulated multi-unit. And we'll see how we know where the screw channels will, the future screw channels will be. So in here you can see the panoramic in the end of the implantation and restoration. You can see that we have different types of multi-units. You know, you can see that we have those two are angulated, you have some straight multi-units, and some of the implants we prefer to put healing caps and don't restore on those multi-units. So after we place the implants, we preferably would like to place an angulated or straight multi-units. If you place in straight multi-units, you know right away where the screw channel will be, because the screw channel will be in the same axis of the implant and right above the implant. When you place in an angulated multi-unit, in many cases, you can see right away where the screw channel will be. You can see here we have two straight multi-units, and you can see by the axis of the hex key of the multi-unit, the positioning and the axis of the future screw channel. When you're using angulated multi-unit, for example, this one, it's hard to know exactly where the screw channel will be. So for angulated multi-units, we have a type of handle that, first of all, it helps us position the multi-unit on top of the implant. And with that handle, we can see where the future axis will be. So in here, the axis of the implant goes right here, right as the axis of the implant, but the axis of the screw channel will be about 30 degrees palatally, which you can see by the handle of the multi-unit.
What is the next step?
The next step is we're taking impressions. Mm-hmm. We, on top of all the multi-unit, we placed scan abutments. We use different types of multi-units. As straight multi-units, we use multi-units V-type. The angulate multi-units are only D-type. So you have two different scan abutments here. You can see by the ring around the scan abutment. We took impression on top of all the multi-units. And with this impression, we made a temporary restoration. The temporary restoration was made next day and screwed to these multi-units.
So, if I understood you correctly, the doctor in this case used all multi-unit level scan abutments.
Yeah.
Not implant level.
No.
Is this the correct way? Won't it be better to use at least one implant level scan abutment?
You don't have to use implant level scan abutment. We talked about it before in the CAD/CAM topic, that you can use implant level scan abutments if you're not sure. But in cases where you're sure what type of multi-unit you'll have, you can use straight the multi-unit, insert it in the implant, and take impression straight on the multi-unit. If you take impression on the multi-unit level, for example, for multi-unit 30 degrees, and this is the multi-unit that was chosen here, this is the maximal angulation that you have. So, for example, if the screw channel will still come out buccally, mm-hmm. you can't have it more palatal, because it's the largest angulation that you have. If the multi-unit is too high, you can always change the height of the multi-unit even though you took impression on multi-unit level. For example, if you chose to use here 30 degrees, 2 millimeters, you can switch it to 31 or 33. But you can't switch to 17 or to straight ones. So in here, the doctor thought, and the doctor was right, because you can see in the next slide that the screw channels was positioned great. The anterior screw channels are all in the palatal region, in the occlusal region. You don't have the screw channels come, any screw channel came up buccally. When you're sure what type of multi-unit you want to use, mm-hmm. when you can see the picture with this handle, you can see where approximately the screw channel will be. You make all the process much more simpler. You don't have to use implant level scan abutment. In this case, the doctor saw the angulation with the handle, and because he saw the angulation, he knows what type of multi-unit, what angulation to use. And you see the result is good. All the screw channels go out to the occlusal area. In the lower implants, he could choose here maybe different angulation, but it doesn't really matter because you can't see it. Later on, it's temporary bridge. He will take impressions again. You have to take impressions again. So you can change this multi-unit, take impressions with angulated multi-unit.
Thank you very much for explaining immediate loading on multi-units.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you for tuning in. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.